Welcome friends, and today's topic is properties of gas mixture. Okay, properties nothing but temperature, pressure, internal energy, enthalpy, entropy, okay, those things which are earlier we studied and completed in the first unit and second unit also. Okay, in the topic we have discussed about the properties of a gas mixtures. Okay, not the individual gas, it is a property of a gas mixture. Okay, the theorem is Gibbs theorem. Okay, in that unit we seen number of laws, okay, for ideal gas and real gas and gas mixtures. Okay, in the topic we have seen number of losses. Okay, these losses are governed the thermodynamic functions. Okay, then the another law is Gibbs theorem. Then the extensive property of an ideal gas mixture can be obtained by an extension of Dalton's law. Okay, of partial pressure. Dalton's law was reformulated by Gibbs. The combined statement is known as Gibbs-Dalton law. Okay, according to this theorem, the internal energies, enthalpies, specific heat of a gas mixture are respectively equal to sum of internal energies, enthalpies, specific heats, etc. of individual components, each at every temperature of and volume mixture. Okay. Dalton's law said the total pressure of a gas mixture is a individual effect or pressure of a or partial pressure of a individual component available in the gas mixture. It's a Dalton's law of partial pressure when volume and temperature remain constant. Okay, then Amagat's law said when pressure and temperature remains constant, the volume of the gas mixture is equal to individual volume or occupied volume of a individual gas, the summation of the individual occupied gases. Okay, volume of the individual occupied gases. This is another version of Dalton's law. And similarly, I extend a certain level to find out the internal energy, enthalpy, and entropy. These things. Okay, with the help of Dalton's law. This law is called Gibbs-Dalton's law because Gibbs extend the Dalton's law to find. To identify or to find these property values. Okay, this value therefore is said the total internal energy or total enthalpy or total specific heat is equal to internal energy of a individual component of a gas mixture or enthalpy of individual component of a gas mixture, specific heat of a individual component available in the gas mixture. Okay, these things he derived. Okay, from that the mathematical concept is the U, overall U equal to U1 plus U2 plus U3 plus U4. For example, here total U equal to UO2 plus UN2 UO2 plus UN2 plus U remaining gases. Carbon dioxide, methane, those things. Okay, remaining gases. Okay, then this is summation of UI. Then intensive property, specific property. Specific property means is what total enthalpy or total property divided by mass. Therefore, M into U because small u equal to capital U divided by M. Okay, which is from, remember the first unit, intensive property, extensive property and specific property. Intensive property dependent of mass, extensive property dependent of mass. Specific property is extensive property divided by mass of the substance. Okay, therefore small u equal is a specific property, therefore which is nothing but capital U divided by M. From that, capital U equal to M into small u. This is M1 U1 plus M2 U2 plus M3 U3. Similarly, summation of MI UI. then the specific internal energy of the specific internal energy of the mixture U equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2 plus m3 u3 divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3, because total m, total mass of the substance, which is equal to m1 mass of the first substance, mass of the second substance, mass of the third substance available in the mixture. Okay, therefore u equal to, you get a formula which is u equal to summation of mi ui divided by summation of mass, um divided by mass. U equal to um is overall internal energy divided by mass, which is nothing but xi by ui. Xi is the mass fraction. Xi equal to what? Xi equal to mi divided by m. Therefore see that equation, m1 by m, m1 by m, m2 by m, m3 by m, because this is completely m. Therefore m1 by m, m2 by m, m3 by m. Therefore m1 by m x1, m2 by m x2, m3 by m x3. Therefore I put xi. Therefore specific internal energy is equal to summation of xi into ui. If mass basis, then mole basis. Mole basis, u equal to n into complementary of um. Das means that means the mole basis analysis. Okay, then u equal to n into um. Similarly, n I into u I. Then u equal to 1 by n into n I u I is y I u I. Y I u I. Mass basis analysis, x I u I is x is equal to mass fraction. Here y I u I, y is a mole fraction. Y is nothing but y I equal to n I by n. Similarly, I can derive that equation, but in previous steps, mass basis analysis is explained in detail. Therefore, I explain briefly for a mole basis analysis. Okay, and here we get two equations. One, u equal to summation of xi ui, then u equal to summation of, sorry, u bar equal to summation of yi ui. This is mass basis analysis, this is mole basis analysis. Okay, anyway, the total internal energy is equal to internal energy of the individual component. Okay, from the equation we have one data. That data is, or we have some knowledge. That knowledge is, or some concept is, total energy is equal to summation of internal energy of the all components. Okay, Anna. Similarly, enthalpy. Same concept. H equal to H1 plus H2 plus H3. And some HI, MI is equal to same, therefore H equal to M1, H1. Similarly, same concept used in a previous steps. Okay, to calculate the internal energy. Therefore, I skip the formulation. Because U equal to M1, U1. Similarly, H equal to M1, H1. Then we get XI, HI. H equal to XI, HI. Similarly, U equal to XI, UI. In mass basis analysis, sorry, mole basis analysis, H bar equal to summation of yi into H I bar. Okay, same equation. Instead of u into H, I substitute instead of u to H. Okay, then similarly entropy same. Yes, S1, S2, S3, MI, SI. From that, small s is equal to summation of XI, SI. And mole basis, S bar equal to summation of YI. Small mistake, which is YI, SI bar. Mole basis analysis. Okay, and similarly, specific heat. MCV equal to M1 C1 V1 plus M2 C2 V2 plus M3 C3 CV3 plus mk cvk, okay, and mi cv, then cv equal to m1 v cv1 plus m2 cv2. Specific heat of whole m and c is called as peak capacity. Then heat capacity m and c, heat capacity means heat capacity, introduce new word, which is equal to m into c, m into c, okay, heat capacity. Heat capacity is a product of mass and specific heat, okay. Then mcv equal to mass of heat capacity of the whole gas mixture equal to capacity of the first gas and capacity of the second gas and capacity of that gas and capacity of the nth gas or kth gas, okay. This is equal to summation of mi into cvi. From that cv equal to m1 cv1 divided by total mass of the substance. From that is cv equal to summation of xi into cvi. Same formula, the notation is different. From internalogy to entropy we have the same formula, same structure, but notation is different. Here u and h and cv and s. Okay, then mole pressure analysis yi. Here the book made some error. Here mole pressure analysis I put yi. Okay, yi. Then these are the properties of a gas mixture. With the help of these formulas we can solve the you will solve the problem with the problem. I stop the topic and tomorrow I start a new topic. Okay, then the problem is a gas mixture of ideal gas consists of 5 kg of nitrogen and 6 kg of carbon dioxide at a pressure of 4 bar and a temperature of 27 degree Celsius. A mixture of ideal gas consists of 5 kg of nitrogen and 6 kg of carbon dioxide at a pressure of 4 bar and a temperature of 27 degree Celsius. Okay, here the mixture having nitrogen and carbon dioxide with different mass proportion and pressure 4 bar and temperature 27 degree Celsius. Okay, then find the mole fraction of the each constituent, the equivalent molecular weight of mixture, the equivalent gas constant of a mixture, the partial pressure and partial volume, the volume and density of the mixture, and Cp Cv of the mixture. And if the mixture is heated at a constant volume to 60 degree Celsius, find the change in internal energy, enthalpy and entropy of the mixture. Take gamma for CO2 equal to 1.286, for N2 equal to 1.4. Okay, gamma we are in first unit I set two equations. One is R equal to Cp minus Cv and gamma equal to Cp by, with the help of these two equations we solved the problems in constant volume, constant pressure and thermodynamic non-flow processes. Okay, here remember these two equations to find out the specific heat and gas constants. That's why they given gamma for CO2 and gamma for N2. Then remember, please recall the molecular weight of the carbon dioxide and molecular weight of the nitrogen. The molecular weight of the nitrogen equal to 28. Okay, then the molecular weight of the nitrogen, sorry, CO2, molecular weight of the CO2 is the molecular weight of the carbon having, the molecular weight of the carbon having 12, oxygen O2 is equal to 32, then the molecular weight of the CO2 equal to 44. Okay, please memorize these things. Okay, in problem they have missed the data, even though you can solve the problem. Okay, m equal to 44 molecular weight of the carbon dioxide equal to 44 or molecular weight of the nitrogen is equal to 28. Okay, then now we go to the problem solution. A gas mixture of ideal gas, mass of N2 5 kg, mass of CO2 6 kg and pressure 4 bar and V2 equal to V1 because the heated at constant volume. Okay, heated at constant volume, therefore V2 equal to V1. Then gamma CO2 equal to 1.28 and gamma N2 equal to 1.4 and T1 equal to 27 degree Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin, and T2 60 degree Celsius plus 273 equal to 333 Kelvin. Then to find number of datas, okay, molar mass fraction, mole fraction, say specific heat, change in internal energy, change in entropy of mixture, partial pressure, the biggest size problem. It's a problem under 12 mark questions. Okay, first, for calculation of number of moles using relation number of moles ni equal to mi divided by mi. Ni, number of moles ni equal to mi divided by mi is a formula. Okay, then mi is for n2 5 kg, mi for co2 6 kg, then mass of molecular weight of co2 44 or molecular weight of the n2 28, and substitute the things and n n2 equal to 0.178, nCO2 equal to 0.136. Then the total number of moles equal to n2 plus nCO2 equal to 0.312. Then now first we calculate the first question, mole fraction. YN2 equal to NN2 divided by N, YCO2 equal to NCO2 divided by N. NN2 equal to 0.178 and total mass is mole is equal to 0.312. With the help of this, you can calculate the YN2 and YCO2. The first question is over. Okay, then second, apparent molecular weight of the mixture, which is nothing but total molecular weight, equivalent molecular weight, which is equal to total molecular weight is equal to individual molecular weight of the substance. Okay, into mole fraction. Then YN2 into MN2 plus YCO2 into MCO2. Total molecular weight equal to mole fraction into molecular weight of mole fraction of the N2 into molecular weight of the N2 plus mole fraction of the CO2 into molecular weight of the CO2. Okay, the total molecular weight is individual molecular weight of the individual component. The individual molecular weight of the individual component is equal to mole fraction into molecular weight of the particular component. Okay, then m equal to, we get 35.1 kilogram per kg mole. It's a molecular weight, 35.1 kilogram per kg mole. Then second, third, apparent gas constant, which is R equal to Ru divided by M. Universal gas constant divided by total molecular weight. Here 0.237 kilojoules kg Kelvin. The procedure is very very simple. The formulas are also very very simple. But the problem seems like a bigger one. Okay. But all formulas and procedure is same for every steps. Okay. Then fourth, the partial pressure and partial volumes. Then PN2 is equal to YN2 into P and PCO2 is equal to YCO2 into P. P is given 4 and 2.28 on 1.78 bar. Then VN2 equal to MN2 RN2 T divided by P. Formula. Okay, Amagad law. This is nothing but Amagad law. Vn2 equal to mn2 rn2 t divided by p. T equal to 300 Kelvin and p equal to 4 bar, which is 400 kilopascal, convert to the kilopascal. And vn2 equal to rn2 is nothing but
universal gas constant divided by molecular weight of the nitrogen is equal to 28. Okay,
8.314 divided by 28. So Rn.
Because overall R equal to overall Ru divided by molecular weight of the overall mixture. But here I substitute only R of nitrogen. Therefore, R of nitrogen which is equal to Ru divided by molecular weight of the nitrogen. And substitute these things. We get volume of the nitrogen equal to 1.13 meter cube. Similarly, volume of the carbon dioxide is equal to 0.85 meter cube. Okay. Then, the volume and density of gas mixture. The overall volume, M volume equal to M into R into T1 divided by P. Overall volume. Therefore, M equal to 5 plus 6, 11 kgs. R is calculated in previous steps. And T1 equal to 300 Kelvin. And P equal to 4 bar, this is 400 kilopascal. Substitute these things. And V equal to 1.954 meter cube. So, volume. Then density equal to mass per volume. Mass equal to 11 kgs. And volume equal to 1.954 and substitute things and 5.63 kilogram per meter cube we get. Okay, then fifth question is over. And Cp and Cv of the mixture. Okay, Cp and Cv of the mixture. Remember the equation. Please remember, it's R equal to Cp minus Cv. Cp minus Cv. Then from that, Cv equal to Cp minus R. Cv equal to Cp minus R. From that, then Cp by Cv equal to gamma, another equation. Okay, from this Cp equal to gamma into Cv. Cp equal to gamma into Cv. Okay, then substitute these things. Cv equal to gamma into Cv minus R. Cv equal to gamma into Cv minus R. Take the small rearrangement. Small rearrangement. R equal to Cv into gamma minus 1. R equal to R this side, Cv this side, then Cv, Cv commonly that is taken from the bracket, then R equal to Cv into gamma minus 1. From this, Cv equal to R by gamma minus 1. Here R is nothing but R in R equal to gas constant equal to Ru divided by molecular weight. And from this Cv equal to Ru divided by molecular weight into gamma minus 1. The common formula Cv equal to Re divided by molecular weight into gamma minus 1. Use this equation for our example. Then Cvn2 is equal to Ru divided by molecular weight of the N2 into gamma of the N2 minus 1. This equation is used in this. I erase the wordings. this equation is used here. Cv n2 is equal to Ru dot rho v, molecular weight of the n2 into gamma of the n2 minus 1. And Cv n2 equal to Ru 8.314 constant, mass of n2 is equal to 28 and gamma n2 is given 1.4. Use this equation, Cv n2 we get. With the help of these, Cp by Cv equal to gamma, then Cv is known, gamma also known, then Cp n2 easily we can calculate. And Cp n2 equal to gamma n2 divided by Cv n2 equal to 1.4 into 0.742, which is 1.039. Okay, Cp of n2 and Cp of n2, similarly Cp of CO2 and Cp of O2, similarly use the same formula, suffix is the different one. Okay, Cp of CO2 is equal to Ru divided by molecular weight of CO2 and gamma CO2 minus 1, molecular CO2 44 and gamma CO2 equal to 1.28, substitute things, then CO2, specific heat of CO2 at constant volume, specific heat of CO2 at constant pressure, we get 0.66 and 0.85. Then overall Cp and Cv, overall Cp and Cv is summation of this. Now use the Gibbs theorem, Cp equal to m into Cv n2, m n2 into Cv n2 plus m CO2 into Cv CO2 divided by m n2 plus m CO2. Substitute these things and finally we get Cp equal to 0.936 kJ per kg Kelvin. Similarly Cv equal to, use same formula, and 0.697 kJ per kg Kelvin. This equation is called Gibbs equation, Cp and Cv. Individual specific heat and mass divided by total mass of the substance. Okay, then change in energy, because at the constant pressure the heating is occurring from 27 degree Celsius to 60 degree Celsius. Therefore the change in energy U2 minus U1 equal to delta U equal to M into Cv delta T. M equal to 11 kg, Cv, now we calculate in previous step. Okay, and substitute this value, and delta T equal to 303 minus 30 degree, 300 degree Celsius, 253.22 kilojoules. Then change in enthalpy of mixture. Change in enthalpy of mixture. Okay, same concept, substitute Cp instead of Cv, simple thing, H2 minus H1 equal to M into Cp delta T. Cp also we had determined, and substitute the value, M is equal to 11 kg and delta T is same, and delta H equal to 3.339.76 kilojoules. And final data is change in entropy, S2 minus S1, at a constant volume, which is equal to MCV ln T2 by T1. Formula. These all formulas are discussed in the first unit itself. Okay. Now we used only, but the formulas are I explained in first unit itself. Okay, delta S equal to S2 minus S1 equal to MCV ln T2 by T1 plus MR ln V2 by V1. Here V2 by V1 0, because V2 equal to V1 at constant pressure. Therefore, MCV ln T2 by T1, M equal to 1 kg, Cv equal to 0.9697 ln T2 333 and T1 300, then we get 0.8 kilojoule per Kelvin, the entropy property values. Yeah, the tedious problem, but very easy steps. Okay, first we calculate the moles and total moles and mole fraction and the gas, overall gas constant and the specific heats and the individual volumes and individual pressures. With the help of this and change in energy, change in enthalpy and change in entropy. So problem, okay, very interesting problem, but the problem is shows like a difficult one and a tedious one. but problem is very very simple. Okay, with problem I conclude the properties of gas mixtures. Tomorrow we will discuss the derivation part of this third unit. Okay, thank you.